And in truth, I understand his position. It is the duty of every soldier to support their leaders in time of war. Asking Martok to stand against Gowron was a foolish error.
So what are you going to do?
Try to convince Gowron to discontinue these attacks. You have said very little.
Look, I'm just not sure that I should be giving you advice on what to do in this situation. It's a Klingon matter.
You are still a member of the House of Martok.
This is the first that I've heard of it.
The General and I talked about it weeks ago. He likes you, and he considers you an honorable woman, a worthy successor to Jadzia. And so do I.
It's very sweet of him.
Sweet?
Not a very Klingon word, is it?
No.
It's very honorable.
Better. Albeit a little obvious. Now, tell me what you think.
Okay. But I'm not sure you're going to like it.
Tell me.
I think that this situation with Gowron is a symptom of a bigger problem. The Klingon Empire is dying. And I think it deserves to die.
You are right. I do not like it.
Don't get me wrong. I'm very touched that you still consider me to be a member of the House of Martok. But I tend to look at the Empire with a little more skepticism than Curzon or Jadzia did. I see a society that is in deep denial about itself. We're talking about a warrior culture that prides itself on maintaining centuries-old traditions of honor and integrity. But in reality, it's willing to accept corruption at the highest levels.
You are overstating your case.
Am I? Who was the last leader of the High Council that you respected? Has there even been one? And how many times have you had to cover up the crimes of Klingon leaders because you were told that it was for the good of the Empire? I know this sounds harsh, but the truth is, you have been willing to accept a government that you know is corrupt. Gowron is just the latest example. Worf, you are the most honorable and decent man that I've ever met. And if you are willing to tolerate men like Gowron, then what hope is there for the Empire?